Hi, Mr. Jones.
Oh, hello.
How are you doing today?
Well, can't complain.
Well, my name is Abby, and I'm going to be your nurse today.
All right.
Would you be able to verify your full name and date of birth for me?
Yes, it's Albert Jones, 19 June, 67.
Wonderful. So today, you have an order from your doctor.
Right.
Or an in-and-out catheter. So do you know what that is?
I think I do. It doesn't sound very pleasant.
Well, actually, so an in-and-out catheter, you might prefer it than probably what you're thinking of as a catheter, because it's literally what it's called. It's in and out. You're not going to have it inside for very long.
Okay.
It's mostly just so you can have it inserted, be able to relieve your bladder, and then it'll come right back out. So it's not for a long time at all.
All right.
And then that procedure can be done every about 6 to 8 hours, really as needed. Or if you don't need the in and out catheter, we won't use it in the future.
Okay, that
really
sounds good.
Yeah, our goal is for you to not have to use the in and out catheter.
All right.
So all right. Is that okay with you?
Yes, thank you, Abby.
Awesome. So before I start, I would like to know, do you have an allergy to latex or shellfish?
Not that I know of.
Okay, that's good. Because some of the products we're going to be using, such as the catheter that we're going to be inserting, we have to be concerned about if you have an allergy to those things.
No, I think we're good to go.
Awesome. So first of all, I'm just going to start out by giving you a little cleansing.
All right.
So we're going to start by cleansing outside and then the inside. And I would use a different washcloth for every area that I cleanse with my next washcloth. I will clean the urinary meatus. Next washcloth, down the shaft. And then if you could just turn over for me, please, and I'll help you to turn over. We're going to cleanse from front to back. All right. So now we're gonna get started with the procedure. So I'm gonna throw away my cloth and change my gloves and sanitize again. So first of all, I'm going to place this pad underneath you.
Okay.
This is just for any spills, anything like that. Next, I am going to put my sterile gloves on. So I'm going to sanitize. And since this is a sterile procedure, I'm just going to ask that you try not to touch anything. This is just for the cleanliness of the procedure.
All right, I understand.
Car. I just give it her a different car. my equipment. So I will apply a lubricant to my little container here. And now I'm going to apply this. Over the penis. So now I cleanse the urinary meatus with three different Q-tips. So it's one, two, and three. Now I'm going to lubricate the tip of my catheter. I'm gonna pull this up here. And could you just bear down for me, please? So you're going to go as if you are urinating.
Oh, yep. You're
able to do that?
I can do that. All right.
Okay. So we're just going to slowly insert this. Just try to relax as much as you can. I know it's not easy.
That's all right. I think it's going all right, don't you?
I think so.
That's good.
So now I'm just going to give it some time so you can empty your bladder.
All right.
All right. Now we're just going to slowly pull the catheter out. And I'm going slowly to make sure there aren't any pockets of urine anywhere. So now I will clean up the equipment. And we are done with the sterile procedure.
Well, that's a relief. So. Thanks, Abby. You so. Girls, you have to do so much. I just don't know.
So I would clean up my equipment. At this time, I would also cleanse my patient again, but for the purpose of this demonstration, I will not. I just, in the case of actual catheter care, I would cleanse after the procedure. And now I am going to check the urine. What I'm going to look at is the volume. I'm also going to look at the coloration, if there's any sediment in the urine, and also how my patient reacted to the procedure in general.